Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at some iPhone typing tricks. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So a lot of us use our iPhones all day long, and we're usually typing on that little virtual keyboard. There are some handy tricks that you should know to make typing easier. So the key to getting to a lot of special functions for the iPhone keyboard is using the icon at the bottom left corner of the screen. It looks like a little smiley face. If you tap and hold that for a fraction of a second, you get a menu. At the top of the menu, you have quick access to keyboard settings. Now you can also go into the Settings app and in General and then go to Keyboard to get there, but this is quicker. Underneath that, we've got a list of all of the keyboards you have. Now by default, you're going to have the keyboard for the main language for your iPhone, so in this case English US, and also the emoji keyboard. But you can have more here. The way to get more is to go into keyboard settings, and then you can see at the top it says keyboards, and I have two. If I tap on that, you can see English and emoji. You can add a new keyboard, and you can see a whole list of different ones. Most of these are for different languages, but also notice that there's one there under third-party keyboards. So when you install an app can include a special keyboard. In this case, the Google app includes the Gboard keyboard, which is a Google keyboard. But there are a lot of other apps, if you search in the App Store, that include keyboards as well. Just search for keyboards or special keyboards. Lots of different things come up. Now at the bottom of this menu, you'll notice three icons, and the middle one is selected. The one on the left and the one on the right are one-handed keyboards. Now you only see these on the iPhone if you're in vertical mode. But if you choose one, you can see it puts the whole keyboard over to that side. And you could easily switch to the other side as well. You also have that little arrow there. You can tap that to go back to the full-size keyboard. And it makes it a little easier to type, especially on the larger screen iPhones with just your thumb as you're holding your phone with one hand. Now a lot of the things I'm going to show you are settings and keyboard settings. You can see I've got them all turned on, but if something isn't working for you, you may want to look to see if you've turned that off. You can see one option there is Smart Punctuation. So the deal with Smart Punctuation is it does two things. One is it will make quotes, curly quotes, to surround the text that you're typing. So if I were to type a quote there, you can see it starts it curling in the one direction, and then if I type quote again, it curls it around in the other direction. So it automatically does that. There is no separate key for those two types of quotes. It does that depending upon if there's a character on the left or a character on the right. Another thing that Smart Punctuation does is if you type the dash twice, it won't actually put two dashes there. It'll convert that to a long dash. Now in settings, there's also a setting at the bottom for period shortcut. If you have that on, what happens is when you finish typing a sentence, if you press the spacebar twice, instead of two spaces, you get a period and a space. So you can see there how it automatically added the period. So I didn't have to actually go to punctuation at the end of a sentence. Now, if you want to use some other punctuation like a comma, you have to tap the little 1, 2, 3 key there. Then you see the punctuation and you can say use that and then tap the ABC key to go back. But you don't actually have to do that. You can do it with a quick slide movement. So I can just tap and hold 1, 2, 3, slide over to the comma, release, and you can see it automatically goes back to the regular keyboard. So tap, slide, and release can take the place of switching keyboards, hitting the punctuation, and switching keyboards back. Now there are more characters you can type than what you can see on the various keyboards. Of course you have the main keyboard here, you go to the number keyboard there, and then you have the special characters keyboard by pressing that key there. But there's even more than that because you can tap and hold some characters and get a list of alternatives. For instance, if I tap and hold some letters like the A key, it will bring up a list of alternatives. A lot of accent marks and things like that. And I could easily select one. It works for some keys but not others. So here, of course, it works for the O key and I could slide over and select one. But it won't work, say, for the G key because there are no alternatives there. The same is true for some punctuation. So I can go into the punctuation keyboard here and I can tap and hold the question mark and you can see I get two options there. Some of the other keys do it as well. Now the same thing is true of emoji at times. So if I go to the emoji keyboard here, I can see all these different ones, and sometimes if you tap and hold emoji you get alternatives. Usually this has to do with skin tone. So if I go to some of these characters here, I can tap and hold. You can see I get different skin tones that I can then select. Now this is one of my favorite tips. It can be sometimes difficult to find an emoji. There are so many different ones. On a Mac, the emoji panel allows you to search for different emoji, which is so handy, but you can't do that here. There's no search field. However, you can search by simply typing what you want. So for instance, if I were to type a word like, say, pie, you could see it comes up with a suggestion there for pie. And I could tap that and it replaces the word with the emoji. Also, if you wanted to keep the word and use the emoji, you can do that as well. So you type a word, when you see one of the suggestions come up, hit the spacebar first. The suggestions stay there and then you could tap one of those and now you have the word and the emoji. It works for a lot of different emoji characters. It helps if you know the actual name of the emoji, but usually you can get it with a few guesses. So I can do things like mad, I can do things like sad, I can do things like smile. Now you have to have the predictive keyboard turned on. So under keyboard settings, make sure you have predictive on, else you won't see those predictions there at the top and can't use this. So one of my favorite features on the Mac is using text replacements, and you can do them here in iOS as well. At the top of the settings, you've got text replacement and you have all of these different words that you can use that will then get replaced by something else. You can easily add one. So say you respond to an email with some text commonly saying I'll get back to you later or something, you could put that as get back later and then have that phrase get back later get replaced with several sentences explaining how you get back later and how they can get in touch with somebody else if they need immediate assistance, that kind of thing. Now a very new feature of iOS 13 is the ability to slide type. So you could see that here in keyboard settings. It's called slide to type, and there's also a setting for delete slide to type by word. So the way to use that is just use it. You don't have to switch to a special keyboard like you may have done before to slide to type. You can do this now with the default keyboard on the iPhone. So you could just basically tap the first letter, slide around to the various letters, and it will then type the word. You don't have to type a space or anything. You can just go right in to doing the next word like that. Now that other setting affects how the delete key works, because since I have it turned on, if I delete now, it deletes the entire word, which is useful because a lot of times when you're using slide to type, it's the whole word that is wrong and you just want to do it again. Now if you try to slide using the spacebar, you get something very different. You get basically a trackpad. If I tap and hold the spacebar, you see how all the keys go away. But now I have a cursor and I can move it around. It makes it so easy to place the text insertion cursor wherever you want. And one last tip for the keyboard is not to use the keyboard at all. We've been using that little smile emoji at the bottom left corner a lot, but there's the one at the bottom right corner as well. And tapping that allows you to do some quick dictation. Hello world. So you can use this. It's super handy for replying to messages or any time that you can talk a little bit easier than you can type. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.